Well, shall I kick off with a video since I think we're more or less present and correct. If I do one of my videos that I've got, and then Paul, would you like to kick us off with a live?
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Brilliant. So Adam, what I'll do is I intersperse the pre-recorded videos I've got with lives,
Yeah.
and so I'll give you a bit of a heads up beforehand, and I know you're going to need some volunteers, aren't you? So I'm going to mute you for a minute, Paul. Sorry. I know you need volunteers, don't you, for your bits?
Yes, please. Yeah, just some people to call out decisions. Nothing
Okay.
difficult.
Brilliant. I'm sure there'll be people willing to chip in. So, okay. So then, this is. Let's see. I've got to try and remember. It's been a while. We haven't met since Christmas. And so I've got to now try and remember how I actually get into my files and share them because I haven't done this for some time. So I think I'm going to start off. I'll hold off on Jen's. But I'm going to start with. Let's see. I think I'll start with one of Tony's actually. And then I know that Isabel, you can't be with us for too long, so I'm going to do yours as the next play-in as well. Okay, so this one then is the first of Tony's contributions. I don't know what one it is. We'll just give it a go.
It's a mad world. All around me are familiar faces, worn out places, worn out faces. Riding early for the daily races, going nowhere. And the tears are filling up their glasses, no expression.
Off. It feels a bit mad at the minute, doesn't it? Anyway, I think Jeff, that might go with your contribution later, actually, that song.
I guess it could, thinking about it.
Jeff's got submitted something a little bit different from him as well this time round, and it's
Oh, is he
brilliant.
going to dance?
Not quite, not quite.
Oh.
But it's brilliant. It is brilliant. Okay, Paul, I'm going to hand over to you.
Have you seen him dance?
No.
Somebody else.
Should
Something
I?
else. I told to Jeff, we were texting earlier on. I said I was going to do a song that we used to do in 1966. This is it. So actually, we used to do the whole album that this song was on, just about.
Thank you.
It's a long and a dusty road. It's a hard and a heavy load. And the folks that I meet aren't always kind. Some are bad and some are good. Some have done the best they could. Some have tried to ease my troubling mind. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound. And I had a girl one time, she had lips like cherry wine. I loved her till my head went plumb insane. But I was too blind to see she was slipping away from me. And my good gal went off on the morning train. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound. And I had a buddy back home, but he started out to run. And I hear he's out by Whitley Bay. And sometimes when I've had a few, his old voice comes a-ringing through. And I'm going out to see that lad someday. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound. Well, if you see me passing by, and you sit and you wonder why, and you wish that you were a rambler too, nail your shoes to the kitchen floor, lace them up and bar the door. Thank the stars for the roof that's over you. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound. No, I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound. Written by Tom Paxton, by the way.
Yes, and you're quite right, Paul. We did any number of songs from that album, didn't we?
We did, yeah. Your album, if I remember rightly.
Yeah, I think it was. We've still got it. I've still got it in the collection. My Lady's a Wild Flying Dove and Last Thing on My Mind and Ramblin' Boy.
That's right. Yeah, I'm going to do the rest later.
Good plan, good plan. I do like the Whitley Bay touch instead of Frisco Bay. Nice one.
Yeah, that was lovely. Very nice. I was going to say who was that by, but yeah, you answered that. That's lovely.
Thank
I really
you.
Like it. It's not something I know that either. But yeah. Right, I think we're going to come to... we're going to play Isabel's now. Well, Isabel's submission, not just Isabel. Do you want to tell us about this one?
Well, just another of Christian's. He's churning them out. I just can't keep up with him mixing them. So, So, as usual, Christian's written it, performed most of it. David's done has done the guitars. And,
And you've mixed it.
I've mixed it. Well,
Okay, I'm going to play that now. What I'll do is we'll play this one and then we'll come to you for your first slot, Adam, if that's okay, if you're ready. Yep, brilliant.
Yeah, perfect, thanks.
Lovely. And then, Dad, you'll be the next live one after that.
What you feel and what you are.
hold on to. Take me to the middle of your.
Oh, that's great. It's good to hear that he's still writing and writing lots by the sound of it. Is that still part of his college course?
No, he's down at Staffs Uni doing sound design.
Oh, fabulous. That's
so
great.
So this is all on top of what he's doing down there. But right. he came back with 20 songs at Christmas. So
excellent. That's really good. Brilliant.
It's a bit more work from my point of view, but anyway, never mind.
But thanks for getting it into us. It's great. Good to hear it. Okay, so now this is something a little bit different. We haven't had anything like this on a virtual open mic before. So I think, Adam, do you want us unmuted for this one? Do you want a bit of audience participation and reaction and interaction?
So, yeah, just one particular person, but I'll get to that in a moment. So, yeah, my name's Adam Hudson. I work as a mathematical illusionist. So I use some mathematics, some magic and some trickery, which I blend together to create the illusion of mind reading or strange savant-like abilities. So what I would like is just one particular person. I'm not going to do anything to embarrass anybody or make them look silly, but if Kate, could you possibly select somebody that might be able to help me with this? It's not
okay.
Difficult.
Okay, I'm going to volunteer Jeff since he's dodged out of frame.
Okay. So, Jeff, can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I can.
Thank you very much for helping out with this. What I'd like you to do, could you name any playing card from within the deck? Possibly not an ace, because everybody always seems to name the aces, but literally any card from within. Could you name one for me, please?
Four of spades.
Four of spades, that's great stuff. When I say an obscure one, not the jokers, no. You'd be surprised how many people try and catch me out by naming the jokers. But the four of spades. And what we're going to do is we're going to create a grid of numbers. So because there's four suits in a packet, we'll start with the number four. But to show how truly random it is, I'm even going to allow you the choice of some negative numbers. So a negative four or negative three, negative two, and I'm going to make a grid. Two, three, and four, five, six, seven. We've got room for one more line, so that would be 8, 9, 10, and 11. Okay, so off this grid of numbers here, could you name any number for me, please, Jeff?
Yeah, minus two.
Minus two, and it's going to be like the lottery. So we're going to circle minus two, so it becomes like a lottery ball, and then we're going to eliminate all of the numbers that are in a straight line from it, both horizontally and vertically. This helps us to speed the process up. There's still a lot of numbers left. Could you name another number for me?
Five.
Number five, the same again. We're going to circle that like a lottery ball. And we'll eliminate all of those in a straight line, horizontally and vertically. There's still a few left. Could you name something else?
11.
11. So let's circle 11. And here and here. And I think the only thing that's left is zero. So it doesn't really matter anyway. So we've got three numbers there, three lottery balls. So tonight's winning numbers, so to speak. And we're going to work out what's called the sum of those numbers, which isn't anything difficult. It just means to literally add them all together. So we have 11 added to 5. That would be 16. And then 16 minus 2 would be 14. So the sum of our numbers is 14, which takes me back to the packet of cards here. And we're going to literally count to the 14th card. If you were with me, you could do this yourself, but completely at fingertips. That would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. This here is the 14th card. So we'll just recap there a little bit. So at the beginning of this, you were asked to name a playing card. I don't know if that's a favourite card, but I think you said the Four of Spades. Is that correct?
Sorry, yes. I need to turn my messages off on here because it came up and interfered. Sorry. Yeah, what did you say?
Was it the Four of Spades that you said?
Yeah, it's a good thing you reminded me because I'd forgotten it by now.
You also had a free selection of numbers. You added them all to these numbers, and when added together, it equaled the number 14. Counting to the 14th card took us to this card here. It would be very strange if this 14th card is your Four of Spades.
Yay! Very good.
Well, doggy.
Brilliant.
Thank you. Excellent. I have something more prepared for you later on as well. So I'm going to sit on the couch. So I haven't disappeared. I'm just offside, just a bit easier on my back. So yeah. I'll join you later on as well. Thank you very much for helping there, Jeff.
Lovely. No problem. That's brilliant, Adam. Thank you very much. We'll come back to you in a little bit. And welcome, Jen. I know you're now here.
Yeah. I wondered when I'd come in on. I thought I'd got in on a...
No, we have something a little bit different this week as well. Excellent. Very good. I like that.
I'm going to have to work out how you did that.
Oh, dear. Well, I think what we'll do is we'll come...
John Lahan used to say, Colin, he did it very well.
Yeah, how did you do that?
He did it very well.
Yeah. Dad, we're going to come to you as the next live, but I'll play a video in... first. Colin, I think I'll play one of yours. Let's see, what should we go for? Shall we play? I'm still trying to get to grips with this. Autumn Leaves?
Yep.
Say anything about this one?
No, not really. It's just a tune I've always liked. It's a really old song. Thousands of people have recorded it. It's become a jazz standard, but not in my hands, unfortunately, but... thank you.
Oh, that was lovely. Like that.
Beautiful. Yeah. Tune.
That's a beautiful tune.
Got some hard chords in it as well.
Yeah, that's exactly what I said to my wife, and she said, "Well, I don't think I know this before you started, but actually, within the first few notes, it's recognisable. It's a fabulous version of it. That's lovely, really nice."
It makes it look so easy, though. Just
yeah, it doesn't he just?
I think his twin brother was doing the difficult bit.
Do you know, I think I must have missed out somewhere there because I didn't recognise that at all. I don't think it's a tune I know. But yeah. I think
I was saying to Sarah that I think I'm pretty sure Willie Nelson's done it. I'm fairly sure he has.
I think lots of people have.
Yeah, and I think Michael Bublé's done it. You know,
really?
It's been done by probably hundreds of people.
It's just
from a 50s film. You know, it was the start of the theme tune for a thing called Kismet.
You're not old enough. That's what it is.
Yeah, that's what it is. You're not old. Do you know what I did? It did sound. I did get kind of glimpses of Moon Over Bourbon Street, though. I don't know whether that's
a couple of phrases
that just sounded a bit similar. Yeah. But Sting did is Moon Over Bourbon Street. Yeah, lovely, gorgeous. I might have to look it up then. I'm obviously sheltered in that respect. Terrible.
Yeah. Also, they find what? The Dead Loops.
Oh, okay. No, it's not familiar at all.
Yeah, the original lyrics were in French, and I think...
Jack Prevert.
I think they were rewritten by Johnny Mercer, I think, the English lyrics. About 1950, something like that.
Very cleverly done. Yeah.
Lovely. Right. Well, we are going to hand over to you now, Dad.
So I was, I thought I can't sing today. So I can't sing much today, but I can't sing definitely today. So I'm going to have a go at doing some readings. And if you want something really old, how about Archie and Mehitabel by Don Marquis, New York. Columnist for a newspaper, that started in 1916 and it went on into the 20s. So basically, Archie is a cockroach who is in fact the reincarnation of a Vers Libre poet from the past, you can tell it's written in the kind of 20s because some of the things that it's about. I think I'll start with the maxims of Archie, in which the very first one that I've chosen is: prohibition makes you want to cry into your beer and denies you the beer to cry into. That sort of gives us a time and a place for it. Later on, he goes on about the founding fathers. That stern and rock-bound coast felt like an amateur when it saw how grim the Puritans that landed on it were. And again, like most columnists, you've got kind of a nice little sort of dry wit. An optimist is a guy that never had much experience. Or every cloud has a silver lining, but sometimes it's difficult to get it to the mint. And procrastination is the art of keeping up with yesterday. So all of these were supposed to be things. They're all written in total lowercase because the only way this cockroach could write and express itself was by hauling itself up onto his typewriter and then throwing itself headfirst onto a key, where it just about with its own weight and speed and enough momentum to make the key work. So there are never any capital letters in Archie and Mehitabel because he can't press the shift key at the same time as the sort of letter key. And he can't, obviously, he just has to be very, very... laborious in what he does. If monkey's glands could restore your youth, what would you do with it? Question mark. Just what you did before? Question mark. Yes, I thought so. Exclamation mark. And one flea says to another, come to lunch with me. I can lead you to a pedigree dog. The other flea says, millionaires and bums taste alike to me. Safety first is my motto. I want to know if he has a muzzle on. And finally, insects have their own point of view about civilization. A man thinks he's a great deal, but to a mosquito, he is merely something good to eat. I'll give you more from Archie and Mahida Boy.
I like that. Very good. Thank you, Dad. Right, let's see. I've kind of run out of plan. Ian and Maureen haven't joined us yet, so I can't go to them for a live. I think Neil McCarty might manage to join us later as well, so I don't want to quite play his yet. Let's go for a Jen and Bob, and then let's come back to Paul. Are you up for that, Paul? Yeah? Lovely. Right, so Jen, I don't know which one this is going to be.
What is this ending?
Let me see. Hang on. It ends in... Oh, a number.
Yeah. What
number is it? How about 444?
Yes, 444. Okay. I thought you might do that, so I actually wrote the number down. So, I can actually say something about this.
Okay.
Usually I say, Bob sings an odd jig about, but I can actually tell you something about this. Okay, so this was a TikTok recent sensation, and it refers to the employees of the Weller Brothers Shipping Company. And in 1833, they were based in Sydney and they were operating like a supply ship to New Zealand. And this is called the Wellerman. But in true form, Bob sings our jig about.
Brilliant. Here we are.
There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Billy at Sea. The wind blew up and her bow dipped down below. Mumbly boys blow. Soon may the Wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. She had not been 2 weeks from shore, and down on her right whale bore, the captain called all hands and swore, we take that bale in tow. Soon may the Wellerman come, to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave. Before the boat had hit the water, the whale's tail came up and caught her. All hands rushed inside her, moved and followed her. She died down below. Soon may the Wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave. For 40 days or even more, the line went slack, then tight once more. All boats were lost, there were only four. Still that whale did go. Soon may the Wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. As far as I've heard, the fight's still on. The line's not cut and the whale's not gone. The Wellerman takes his regular call. Encourage the captain, crew and all. Soon may the Wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave. Soon may the Wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, take out.
And tonguing is the nautical term, just in case they think.
Oh, great.
It gave me a chance to wear my pirate girl top.
Excellent. Thank you very much for that, Jen. That's brilliant. Okay. Hi, Ian. Hello. Ian, I'm going to put you in for a live soon.
Right.
We're low on numbers today. I think everybody's off partying, obviously. February is not quite the low month that it seems. Everybody's out doing stuff. Okay, so we're going to come to you next then, Paul.
Well, I wouldn't call rehearsing partying.
Well, no. I mean, three. Mum's at. There's a few rehearsing. That's fun.
All right. I'll do this one by way of thanking Mike for playing it on his show and plugging my CD. Sales have gone through the roof. That's all you're doing. This is Happy Blues, and you'll have to imagine the harmonica solo. And it goes something like this. Woke up this morning, I was feeling all right. I knew I'd see my lady tonight. I never felt this good since I don't know when. And each time we part, I can't wait to see you again. With your laughing eyes and your long blonde hair. You got me floating, I'm walking on air, and there's a spring in my step that wasn't there yesterday. Oh, I feel so good, these wings might just take me away. When I'm by myself and I'm feeling all alone, oh, I can call you on the telephone. I'm searching like a boy any fool can see. And I can't believe you'd fall for a dreamer like me. Not the kind can tell you how I'm feeling. My tongue gets tired and my head starts reeling, and the words won't come. The song will have to do. So I picked up my guitar and I wrote a happy blues for you. When I woke up this morning, I was feeling all right. I knew I'd see my pretty lady tonight. I never felt this good since I don't know when. And each time we part, I can't wait to see you again. No, each time we part, I can't wait to see you.
Super.
Thank you. Happy Blues.
Yeah, love that. So did you actually get quite a few sales then from the off the back of the show? Or
one from me.
Hey!
There you go.
The traditional response to that is, I mean, mum bought one then. But I can't even claim my mum as a listener.
Have you got a copy, Mike?
I have a. I did a. In order to get it onto the show, we did a rip off of the one you sent to Kate. So I've got it on my iTunes, and hopefully we'll play some more different.
You've bootlegged it, in other words.
Completely ripped it off.
Hey, Paul.
And I know the streams are only a penny a time anyway. My hope is always.
Hey, you know it.
To buy stuff.
You know you've made it, Paul, when you've been bootlegged, pal.
Well,
you're there.
If you message me your address, Mike, I'll send you a copy.
Oh, brilliant. Thank you.
I found Paul's music page from it.
Sorry?
What was that, Jen?
I found Paul's music page from it and give him a like.
Brilliant. Thank you very much, Jen. Appreciate that.
Excellent. Excellent.
Hopefully gigs will be starting this year.
Oh, I hope so.
I've had a gig come flooding in.
Have you? Just the one?
I was reading Lars McCarthy's sort of plea. It's just amazing how even the kind of people we think of almost as folk royalty.
Did you hear that Norma had actually passed away?
Yeah.
Very sad. Lovely lady.
Yeah.
Got a couple of attacks on tomorrow.
Not tomorrow. Great Sunday. Loss.
Yeah. She was one of those people, if you saw her at a festival, I'd never heard of her, and she stopped me in my tracks. Yeah. I was sort of walking past the tent in the marquee. What's that? And it's just this big, powerful sound. Oh, God.
The thing is, you know, she's that, I suppose, just because of the fact she started her career singing with the Watersons, you know, that's with her brother and sister and cousin, she had to hold her own. So, you know, all four voices had to be big and loud, especially Mike Watson's voice.
Oh, beautiful voice, Mike had. Mm. Huge fan.
Yeah. It's very, very sad news. I mean, in some ways, you know, her voice will live on to Eliza, because Eliza's voice is
so similar.
Very, very similar. Definitely genetic, that voice.
On the gift, it's really hard to work out which is her and which is normal.
So I bought them a coffee on their site, because I think it's just awful, and there's still not an end to the you know, we just don't know when things are going to properly open up, and festivals and things are going to start back up properly. So I know that they're still struggling. So anyway, we're going to move on from that terribly sad note. And I'll play another video, and then Ian, if we can come to you after that.
Okay.
Right, lovely. So this one then, let me play the first of Coltrum's. So Jeff, did you want to say anything about this one? I'm going to play the one that you suggested goes first.
Yeah, I can't remember which one that was now.
It's
No Frontiers.
Yes, No Frontiers.
Okay, yeah, this is No Frontiers, and I'm a bit remiss because I haven't looked her cut up. I don't know if this was a Jimmy McCarthy song, Irish writer. Someone might be able to tell me. But anyway, this is a song we kind of got the idea, or I got the idea, to put to Michelle. It comes from a Mary Black album. I think the album was called No Frontiers, if I remember rightly. And I think Michelle's not even here, so I can say what I like, really, can't I? I think she does a great version of this, actually. And you might actually, if you look carefully, you might see me sort of singing along in the video, because it's like a lip sync thing going on. The thing is, I was going to do the harmonies, but actually Michelle did such good harmonies with herself that's what I mixed into the sound. So it's got kind of, you know, all sorts of backing and things, but we actually put the video together last night. Last minute job, definitely. I hope you enjoy it. But this is No Frontiers. Yeah.
Life is a river and your heart is a boat. I'm just like a water baby, born to float. And if life is a wild wind that blows way on high, and your heart is Amelia, dying to fly. Heaven knows no frontiers, and I've seen heaven in your eyes. And if life is a barroom in which we must wait, round the man with his fingers on the ivory gates, where we sing until dawn of our fears and our fates, and we stack all the dead men in self-addressed crates. In your eyes faint as the singing of a lark, but somehow this black night feels warmer for the spark, warmer for the spark to hold us till the day when fear will lose its grip and heaven has its way. Heaven knows no frontiers, and I've seen heaven in your eyes. And your spirit's a slave to man's whips and man's jails, where you thirst and you hunger for justice and right, then your heart is a pure flame of man's constant night. In your eyes faint as the singing of a lark, but somehow this black night feels warmer for the spark, warmer for the spark to hold us till the day when fear will lose its grip and heaven has its way. And heaven has its way when all will harmonize. They know it's in our hearts, the dream will realize. Heaven knows no frontiers, and I've seen heaven in your eyes. Heaven knows no frontiers, and I've seen heaven in your eyes.
Oh, it was gorgeous. That was really lovely. Beautiful. That one I do know.
Yeah, yeah. It was Jimmy McCarthy, by the way. I looked up while that was playing.
Yeah, that was lovely. Isabel sends apologies to leave in the middle of that. She had to go. She's got another Zoom call that she had to join. But, hopefully she'll join us again next month. So, have we lost Ian?
No,
I
was trying to be sophisticated and use my Epoch cam,
right?
So you could actually, I could face you and play, but it's not working. Well, it should be. I've switched it on. I'll just try again. No, I've got three dots, and you know that kind of. I'll be with you in a minute. Right. So you. You'll have to put up with me singing down me, looking down my ear while I sing. Okay, this is a song about a very bizarre situation, and how bizarre it is will become evident. She's a whole lot of woman, I ain't gonna lie. When she gets a bit to drink, she gets a glint in her eye. Like I'm a first prize, she's the winner. I'm on the menu and she's having me for dinner. She spins me a line, I'm frightened to catch it. She's got an itch and she's gonna scratch it. My best friend's little girl,
terrifies me. Her daddy and me stayed up and got tight when she was born. One hot summer night, the years flew by. His little girl has grown. She's married now, with kids of her own. She likes to party, she's a bit of a devil, but she takes flirting to a whole new level. My best friend's little girl terrifies me. See my unease increase with every bottle she kills. When she heads my way, I know it's time to head for the hills. Any time of day, they say she's cool and sophisticated, but it starts to slip. She loses her grip when she's lubricated. Does she want to abuse me? Does she want to confuse me? Of all the people, why does she go choose me? My best friend's little girl terrifies me. Her husband and my wife last smile at the state of affairs, while I get chased around the house and up and down the stairs. My curious plight is a source of delight to her family. She pours her head, my hair, and a drink and herself all over me. I know it might sound tight-assed, might sound vain, churlish for someone my age to complain, but my best friend's little girl, she terrifies me. At the start of the night, she's funny and bright and so attractive, but when she hits her stride, she gets pie-eyed, she's radioactive. She thinks I'm cool, she thinks I'm ace, but only when she's totally off her face. My best friend's little girl terrifies me. My best friend's little girl terrifies me.
is that autobiographical?
You what, Jeff?
Is it autobiographical, that one?
I don't know. It's about me, though.
All right. Okay. Yeah.
It's She was absolutely sort of smashed one night, and she started to kind of be really. She's saying, "You're cool. You're so effing cool. You're effing cool. You are." And she had me against the wall, and I didn't know whether she was. Is she kind of like? Does she mean I'm cool, or does she really hate me, or does she like me, or is it's like I was totally confused, and her mother kind of like berated her terribly, and it's okay, I don't know. So she apologized, and everything was cool. And the next time we were at a dinner party, and the same look came into her eye. Oh no! And she. Yeah, cool.
It's like the groupie from hell.
Yeah, and I was putting my coat on to go. She said, "Where are you going?" We're going home. I've got to let the dogs out. And so I've got another abject apology, and I just don't know what to do about it. I don't know what it's all about at all, and I don't know if she does, because she doesn't remember anything about it.
Oh.
Well, that's a good thing to drink, I suppose.
Yeah. I played it at a wedding, it was very nice. But she said she'd got some nice flowers, and it was okay if she put them on either side of my keyboard. And she says, "I can't wait to get my tulips around your organ."
It's no joke, but we like
it. Oh, dear.
You mean that was all constructed just
it to... It was, yeah.
You really are. You're so predictable. It was good, though. There was me when I was looking down your ear when you were playing. I was kind of waxing lyrical.
Oh. as we hurtle towards the bottom, competing with each other. Joke.
Oh dear.
Yeah, so that's my best friend, little girl.
Excellent. Right, let's see. Now, where are we at in terms of lives? I think, Adam, I'm going to leave you till a little bit later because I know this the next one is your last one. So, Dad, can we come back to you for your next thing? So I'll play a video first. Do you know what? I think I'm going to play a couple, actually, because I've got a few. So I think what I'm going to do is play a two Bobs and then I'm going to play something else. I don't know what yet. I'll think about it while I'm playing this, I think. So this is actually, I haven't heard anything from Bob and Bob this month. I did send them a message, but haven't heard anything. But for the Christmas special, they sent in about 5 different videos and we couldn't fit them all in. So I've had to bump, I think, 3, and I've chosen 2 to play in tonight. So this is the first one of those. And this is Lucky Man.
He had white horses and ladies by the score, all dressed in satin and waiting by the door. What a lucky man he was. What a lucky man he was. White lace and feathers, they made up his bed. A gold-covered mattress on which he was laid. Ooh, what a lucky man he was. Ooh, what a lucky man he was. He went to fight wars for his country and his king, of his honor and his glory, the people would sing. Ooh, what a lucky man he was. Ooh, what a lucky man he was. A bullet had found him, his blood ran as he cried. No money could save him, so he laid down and he died. What a lucky man he was. What a lucky man he was. What a lucky man he was. What a lucky man he was.
Okay, so not two Bobs, that one. Bob and John. So, yeah, I have got a two Bobs, though, to play as well. Okay, Dad, we're going to come to you then.
Yeah, so this is just a sort of another bit of that, this writing from the cockroach's point of view. Laborious, that's the word I'm after, laboriously done by hauling himself up onto the typewriter. Let's see, this went on in the 20s for a long time. The book of Archie and Mehetabel is still in print. So it's this is one of them. This is called Warty Bliggins the Toad. I met a toad the other day by the name of Warty Bliggins. He was sitting under a toadstool, feeling contented, and he explained that when the cosmos was created, that toadstool was especially planned for his personal shelter from sun and rain, thought out and prepared for him. "Do not tell me," said Warty Bliggins, "that there is not a purpose in the universe. The thought is blasphemy." A little more conversation revealed that Warty Bliggins considers himself to be the center of the said universe. The earth exists to grow toadstools for him to sit under. The sun to give him light by day, and the moon and wheeling constellations to make beautiful the night for the sake of Warty Bliggins. To what act of yours do you impute this interest on the part of the creator of the universe? I asked him. Why is it that you are so greatly favoured? "Ask rather," said Warty Bliggins, "what the universe has done to deserve me." If I were a human being, I would not laugh too complacently at poor Warty Bliggins. For similar absurdities have only too often lodged in the crinkles of the human cerebrum. Archie.
Could I just ask, could you hold the book up again that you did hold? You nearly did it again then, but you didn't. Could you hold the book up again so we can see it and see who it's?
Archie Mehetabel. That's where Warty Bliggins comes from. I've never known.
Well, there you go.
About Warty Bliggins.
It's Don Marquis.
Yeah. I have to say I'm giving you my choice selection from the whole book. So it's not all, I don't think, as brilliant as Warty Bliggins.
if that's the peak, you know.
there are other bits and so on, but it's and the whole idea is a fun idea, I think, you know, kind of the concept is really
good. Yeah. I am going to suggest that I play another video and then we have a little break. Because we've been going for about, well, a little over an hour now. I think I've probably got more videos than I've got lives. I'm going to chase up Neil and see if he is going to manage to join us, because he may well do something live if he is. But what I'll do is I'll play another. I think I'm going to play another of yours, Jeff, your second Coltrane one. Do you want to say anything about this one?
No, except that this was actually also inspired by the Mary Black version of the same song. There's purists around who also say, "Oh, it should never have been done by anyone else but the original," which, yeah, maybe. But I think people can do good versions of songs and do good covers. And I actually think Mary Black did a great cover of this particular song.
But I think, I think Michelle does rather an excellent version of it as well. She gives it her own stamp in a sense, I suppose. But anyway, so this is the old Aretha Franklin song, Say a Little Prayer.
Excellent. Here we are. How it must be to live without you would only mean heartbreak for me. I run for the bus, dear. While riding, I think of us, dear, and say a little prayer for you. At work, I just take time and all through my coffee break time. I say a little prayer for you. Forever, forever, you'll stay in my heart and I will love you. Forever and ever, we never will part and I will love you. Together, together, that's how it must be. To live without you would only mean heartbreak for me. I'm in love with you. Answer my prayer now. Say you love me too. Just answer my prayer now. Say you love me too. Oh, forever, forever, you'll stay in my heart and I will love you forever and ever. We never will part. Together, that's how it must be. To live without you would only mean heartbreak for me. The moment I wake up, before I put on my makeup, answer my prayer now. Say you love me too. Just answer my prayer now. Oh, that's gorgeous. Nice. Lovely. Really nice.
Nice burbling harmony, Jeff.
Yeah. I try and keep a low profile with it, Ian. You know that. I think that maybe I could have been a tad louder than that, but you know, it was there. It was kind of audible, which is, you know, a shame really. But I mean, anyway, no. I'm Michelle's not here, but I really love the version she sung of that, and we actually did one take of that, and we had not recorded it before last night, and we've been trying to get it right for about a year. Because that bit in the middle that sort of does the bits with the answers that I was doing, we could never get it right. We never got the right number of them for going back in. You know, so it got a bit confusing. It took us a year to actually finally get that down. And Michelle did it in one take last night.
Lovely. So, Really nice. Quick break, chat amongst yourselves, chance to top up drinks and nip to toilets and things like that. And we'll come back again in a minute and I will play us in with another video. One. Okay, so this one is, I think I must have played that one of Tony's already, so I'll check that out in a minute. So this one is a second of his. He's got definitely got a black and white thing going on this month, so here's his second contribution.
"You'll Shine When It Shines" by the Ozark Mountain Daredevils. "The old cat on the roof, he could stand a little push, 'cause he's got nine lives to give. But like my mama said, you only live until you're dead, so you gotta give and give. There's a leaf in the wind, I don't know where to end, chasing fears and tears and troubles along. And there's a pebble in the pond, rolling on and on, making waves and tides and ripples. Everyone is out looking for the sun, singing rain and pain, and he that hesitates. But it'll shine when it shines, and you might think I'm wasting time, but I'm just a good old boy that's learned to wait. Whippoorwills in the dawn, soon he'll be gone, but he's got one good song to sing. It's like what Daddy said, it's in your heart and not your head, so you gotta sing and sing and sing. And there's a window in the wall, looking out all, chasing fears and tears and troubles along. And there's a fire in the stove, keeping out the cold, warm and wine of winters and babies and homes. Seems like everyone is out looking for the sun, singing rain and pain, and he hesitates. But it'll shine when it shines, and you might think I'm wasting time, but I'm just a good old boy that's learned to wait. Yes, I'm just a good old boy that's learned to wait.
Really nice to hear that. I've forgotten all about the Ozarks.
Yeah, yeah, that was lovely. Right, so we've got the third of Tony's coming up a bit later then, this third and final. Jen, I'm going to play yours next after Ian. So, Ian, we'll hand over to you.
I never know whether to sing sort of like serious songs or silly songs. I find a lot of silly songs that I've written, and so I'll do a silly song because I'm like that. I wrote this when years ago they Granada TV did a program about Maryport, because Maryport had qualified for £6 million worth of funding from the EEC, and Border Television didn't bother about it because, you know, it wasn't that interesting. But Granada did it, and I watched the program, And it was fascinating the way that they approached Maryport from somebody who didn't live there and knew nothing about it. And it had they did it in a quite glamorous way, so that you didn't see the bus station, you didn't see anything beyond the bridge of the harbour. And it was like the kind of shrink-wrapped this marina onto Maryport, the original marina. So this is a song about waiting for millionaires, which there still are in Maryport. are there? Sunlight from... No, it's the wrong speed. Sunlight from a western sky hits the fresh new paint and dazzles the eye. There's a silent, expectant air. We're waiting for millionaires. The builder's away and his scaffolding's gone. We've got the prams out of the riverbed. The coloured lights are on outside the harbour cafe with its white plastic chairs. Now all we need are millionaires. Couple of things we still haven't got. Bimbos in bikinis on a whacking great yacht. Maryport marinas, sharp and slick, like a Hollywood film set. Two bricks thick, Juan Lepin, Saint-Tropez. No, we're not going there. We're going to Maryport. They'll say we'll meet the rest of the international jet set there, where you can't move for millionaires. Beyoncé's in our domino team now. Admittedly, the sun doesn't shine every day. The sea's not turquoise or a murky kind of grey. There's a chemist and a co-op and a laundromat, and it's handy for Sellafield. Forget I said that. Juan Lepin, Saint-Tropez. Mais non, mon ami, allons à Maryport, they'll say. We'll meet the rest of the international jet set there. You can't move for millionaires. It's heaving with millionaires. The chip shop's selling mushy peas in baguettes, black pudding paninis.
That was fabulous.
Very good.
Love that.
Long time out of date now.
That reminded me, have you ever heard a chap called Jeremy Taylor?
Yes.
The sort of stuff he used to write, you know. Just every bit is good. Fabulous.
Oh, that's very kind of you.
I loved it.
I'll have to go and listen to him and kind of get upset now.
That Paul's absolutely right. It didn't occur to me actually when you were doing the song, but yeah, it's very good. Jeremy Taylor, yeah, that's that kind of humour. All right. Along the south coast.
Yeah. The sea is sort of there.
Yeah.
That's Benjamin.
I was so quietly proud. I actually rewrote it for the choir, and it was about heading down to Maryport Blues. And when they stopped the blues festival, I said, well, the song's still fine. They said, no, you can't sing it anymore because they don't do the Maryport Blues Festival. And I feel quite miffed because, you know, when you say anything down by the harbour in the evening light, Dinah's got a fella who's thinking Dinah might be clearing for action. I mean, there's not many people, you know, I was rather proud of that.
Yeah.
Gone.
Oh, dear. It was excellent.
Thank you.
Very good. Hi, Stephen. Haven't seen you for a little while. Nice to see you. Stephen just joined in the middle of that. I think Tony's back home now as well. So although he's missed a couple of his, he'll hopefully join us before I play in his last one. So I think what I'm going to do now is play Jen and Bob's final one before Jen slips away. And then we'll come back to Neil. So, Jen, did you want to say anything about this one?
It's just a little one that I think you'll all recognise it. but it's just a take on one of the original. The original one was in the early 50s, and it was done by the Dixie Cups. But you'll know it as soon as you hear it, you'll know it.
That's excellent. It. Thanks, Jen.
My bestie and your bestie sit down by the fire. My bestie, say you want a party? Can we make the flames go higher? Talking about hey now,
hey now,
hey now,
hey now.
I go, Andy. Giacomo Fina, Giacomo Fina. Stop my truck, let's all jump in. Here we go together. Nice cool breeze and big palm trees. Till I don't get no better. Talking about hey now,
hey now,
hey now,
hey now.
I go on me. Giacomo Fina, Giacomo Fina. Shout out to the good time crew all across the islands. Grab your shoes in two by two, shining bright like diamonds. Talk about hey now,
hey now,
hey now,
hey now.
I go on me. Jump a muffin now, I'm aye. Jump a muffin aye. My bestie and your bestie sit down by the fire. My bestie says she want a party. Make the flames go higher. Talking about hey now,
hey now,
hey now,
hey now.
I go on me.
Jump
a muffin, hey now, hey. Jump a muffin, hey. Jump a muffin, hey. Jump a muffin, hey.
Woo!
Yay! That was great.
One of our little grandchildren, the five-year-old, he's learning the uke with me. So I set him up in the bedroom with his own uke stand, and he wanted a plectrum, so he does it with a plectrum. But the funny thing was, when his little 14-month-old brother saw that video, his first words now are, hey now.
Well, so Jen, were you kind of rocking like a Munich beer sort of festival?
Yeah. Actually, you didn't see the previous video, and that was a sea shanty. Oh. I hadn't time to get changed.
It's a pirate's outfit.
It's a pirate top. Yeah. Adam is dead close.
Do you think we should have a fancy dress night?
I think we should have a fancy dress night one night.
Yeah.
I do a suspiciously good Father Jack.
But be too good.
Do you know what? I can see that, Ian. I can just see it.
That would be an ecumenical matter.
I think that's my favourite Father Ted quote ever, Neil. far away.
Yeah, no, there's an even better one than that, you know. The people don't. Father Jack was, they got him to sort of like to judge the wet T-shirt competition. And all you see is all these girls at the back to him. There's a guy spraying water on them, you see, and he's there just like, he gets the microphone, you know, the loud hail, he goes, more water, more water.
Oh, dear. On that note, Neil, we're going to hand over to you. Can I just check before you start, actually? Hi, Tony and Stephen, can I ask, do you have something for us this month, or are you just listening today?
I have something today, yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Brilliant. I will put you in, I'll find a place for you to go, maybe alongside Dad, I think.
Okay, all right.
Okay. All right, Neil, it's over to you.
Okay, this is by, I don't know who it's by, I forget. Never mind, we'll try it.
Remember when the days were long and rolled beneath the deep blue sky? Didn't have a care in the world with mommy and daddy standing by. But happily ever after fails. We've all been poisoned by these tales. The lawyers dwell on small details. Since daddy had to fly, you can lay, but I know a place where we can go, still untouched by man. We'll sit and watch the clouds go by and the tall grass wave in the wind. You can lay your head back on the ground. Let your hair fall all around me. Offer up your best defense. This is the end. This is the end of the innocent. Spacious skies, now those skies are threatening. The beating plow shares into swords with this titled man we call king. Armchair warriors often fail, we're poisoned by these fairy tales. The lawyers dwell on small details since daddy had to lie. But I know a place where we can go, but flush away the sin. We'll sit and watch the clouds go by and the tall grass wave in the wind. You can lay your head back on the ground. Let your hair fall all around me. Offer up your best defense. This is the end. This is the end of the innocence. Who knows how long this will last? We've come so far, we've come so fast. Somewhere back in all the dust, that same small town in each of us. I need to remember this, so baby give me one last kiss. Let me take one last look before we say goodbye. You can lay your head back on the ground. Let your hair fall all around me. Offer up your best defense. This is the end. This is the end of the innocence.
Oh, that was brilliant. Don Henley and Bruce Hornsby.
That's right.
It's written by Bruce Hornsby, but sung by Don Henley. That's, you know, yeah. Something like that, yeah.
Yeah, that was super.
I should write it down because I've got a memory like a colander. You know?
Google's a wonderful thing.
Elizabeth thinking you were the fountain of all knowledge.
I've blown my cover there.
No idea how much I'm battered by that.
I should have kept that secret, shouldn't I? Oh, no, that was lovely. I really enjoyed that. Thank you. Right, so we're going to do another video and then we're going to come to Adam for you for your second session. I will choose somebody different. I won't pick on Jeff again. We've relieved Jeff. And see, I'm a teacher. The kids that hide at the back of the class, they're the ones I pick. Right. Let's see, what should we have next? I'm afraid I played one of yours, Tony, just before you arrived, I'm afraid. So I've only got one of yours left, but I'll hold on to that for just a minute. Let's go for the second of Colin's. Any preference on which one I play next, Colin?
I'm not too bothered. Nope, whatever.
Okay. So I was hoping you were going to pronounce them.
Do the one that you can't pronounce, because I can't pronounce it either.
All right.
The Pulula.
Pulula.
Yeah.
I'm reading it now. Pulula.
Can I just say that? Before I do this, that ever since Mike described me on his radio program as someone who treats the ukulele as a serious instrument, I've been under terrible pressure. Things I've suffered. Just joking. It's a dirty job. But some deluded fool has to do it.
Oh dear. Okay.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah, this is just a little tune I came across while trawling on the internet looking for stuff to play. Apparently, the name, if you can pronounce it, it's the name of the Hawaiian state butterfly, which looks alarmingly like a red admiral to me, but I may be wrong. I think it's the same group.
Oh, okay. I might have to look that up now. To Google to the rescue again. All right, well, here it is. Oh, it was lovely.
Red Admiral.
Yeah, definitely. I was just going to say, I found a photo of it, but you beat me to it there. Lovely. Really gorgeous. Okay, so we are going to come to Adam next, and the second of your slots. And then I think what we'll do after that, we'll have a video, and then we're going to come to Stephen, and then Paul straight after Stephen with no video because
there's someone in half left to it.
So yeah, so Adam.
All right, Sarah's just said sorry. If Adam's going to saw someone in half, can he wait until she gets back? Sorry,
Adam. Sorry, you'll have to unmute yourself again because I muted you again. So it'll give Sarah a chance to get back anyway.
Can you hear me okay?
Yep, perfect.
Excellent. If I do remember the Tuitt's advert,
I do,
and I even seem to remember it used to say even chewier than Barrow-in-Furness bus depot. I was living in Barrow-in-Furness at the time. Can you remember that?
I don't remember that bit, but yeah.
When you were saying about selecting people, like participants, normally when I'm on stage, I'll throw a piece of a scrumpled up ball of paper out to select somebody. But people normally, scarper, I've thrown out a hand grenade. Nobody looks anywhere near it. Okay, did you manage to pick somebody that would help me out with this next thing?
Well, I'm looking around. You know what? Neil's not muted. I'm going to pick on Neil.
Excellent. Neil would be perfect. Neil, can you hear me okay?
Yeah.
Good. Neil, what I'd like you to do is, I don't want you to say anything out loud. This is just in your mind. I want you to think of a colour when I click my fingers, okay? So when I click my fingers now, just think of a colour. Just say yes or no when you've got one.
Yes.
Yeah, brilliant. And now when I click my fingers again, I want you to change to a different colour or a new colour. So think of a new colour now. Have you got a new colour in mind?
Yep.
Okay. What was this new colour that you went for?
Grey.
Grey, okay. Well, that's your second choice, your secondary choice. You also thought of a first choice, like a primary choice. What was the primary colour you went for?
Blue.
Blue, that's interesting. And it's interesting because you went for a secondary choice, but you also went for a primary choice of blue. And I'm interested in that instinctive choice for the next thing we do. But when I was saying about the piece of paper here, see, there's a message inside it. If I just unscrumple this. And the message is that your primary colour will be blue.
Yeah.
So we'll get the reason I'm talking about colours is because I have a cube here which has got a colour on each side. I've also given each side a mnemonic. I'm going to mnemonic link to each side. So this side here is closest to me. So I'm going to put a playing card suit to each side. So this is close to me. So that would be clubs because it's a CL at the start. So every time we see a club, I'll turn this side. This side here is closest to you guys, the spectators. So again, that SP, that would be spades. So spectator side for spades. And then we'll use high for hearts. And we'll use down for diamonds. So clubs is close to me, spades for the spectators, high for hearts, and down for diamonds. Let me just, as much as it pains me, because it took me ages to solve it, I'm going to mix it, okay? I don't know. Are you familiar with blackjack at all?
No.
No.
I don't really know much about cards at all, quite honestly with you.
That's okay. This is going to be quite simple because it's only loosely based on it. You're going to get a choice of stick or twist. So I just need some cards. I'm going to use about a third of the pack here. So I'm going to deal cards. Every time you say the word stick, I'm just going to deal one card down onto the table. I'll move this back so you can see the cards.
Yeah.
But when you say the word twist, I'm going to take the second card, place it on top of the first, reverse in their order, and then place them both down on the table. Okay? And we're going to go through all of these cards, this small packet. So stick or twist to start with.
Okay.
Twist to start with, yeah. And the next one?
Twist.
Twist again. There's a song in there, isn't there?
Twist.
Again. Okay, so second we'll swap those two. And the next again.
Stick.
Stick.
Twist. Twist.
Very good.
And stick. And stick. And stick. And stick. And stick. How many have you got left?
About five.
Okay. Twist.
Twist for this one? Yeah.
Stick. Stick. And stick.
On the last one. Okay. So that places it into a random order which has been governed by your choices. So we're going to see how we get on with this. So the first one is a heart. I'll show them to you. So it's that one here. So that was high for hearts. So that would be here. And the next one is a spade. So that would be spectator side for spade. The next one is a club. So that would be close to me for clubs. And then we have a heart, high for heart. Spade, spectator side again for spades. Then it's a diamond. So we'll go down for diamonds. The next one is another diamond. So that would be down for diamonds again. Then it's a heart. So up high for the heart again. And we'll see what the next one is. The next one's a spade. So that's a spectator side for spades. Then the next one is a heart. High for hearts again. Then it's a spade. So we'll go spectator side for spade. This side here is clubs. So that's close to me for the clubs. And then we have high for hearts once more. That's this one here. And it's spectator side for spade. So that's your side over there. Diamonds, or down for diamonds at the bottom. Down for diamonds on the bottom again. We have hearts, up high for hearts. Let's give that one a twist. This time it's spades, or spectator side for spades. This time we have hearts, high for hearts. And then we have a spade, the ace of spades, spectator side for spades. And the last one is a club, which is my side for clubs, which means that you did that absolutely perfectly.
Oh my goodness.
With your suppressed digitation, did you? There was a thing on Facebook. In America, they got this computer that can solve a Rubik's Cube from any random selection in something like about 0.3 of a second.
The manually, like for a human being to do it, the world record is something like 4 seconds.
Yeah. Obviously, it hits that, it goes, and it's done. You know?
Yeah.
Some Chinese boy juggling three of them.
Yeah. That was amazing, Adam. Really, really good.
That's really clever, that. Really clever.
Absolutely fantastic. Well done. Will you join us again?
Everything I've performed this evening, this is like all the banners and things, these are my own books. Like I wrote all this material myself, but I started off as a magician, but I changed my style in 2003 when I was a very early age. I was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis. So I realised that I might have trouble with like dexterity, which like you might associate with a magician. So I do a lot of things, a lot of magic, which is very suitable for an audio-based audience. Like, I can do things over the telephone, which is unique to me.
Well, we'd definitely love to have you back on an open mic night and potentially in the theatre. I mean, usually we're running as a hybrid now with people in the theatre as well, but because the pantomime was delayed, they're rehearsing tonight because the panto's in a couple of weeks. So so we're sort of fully virtual now. But yeah, so it'd be nice to see you there in the theatre. Where are you based?
I'm based in Dalton in Furness, which is in between Ulverston and Barrow.
Oh, so you're quite away from Wigton then still.
Yeah, but... Yeah.
But that's one of the reasons why we do Zoom, is so that people from the park join in, because I'm even further away than you are, because I'm in London. So,
okay.
So it kind of works that way. But yes, please come back and join us. And,
I would love to.
Yeah, definitely.
I'll probably slip off about 9:45, so if you haven't finished, I'll give my apologies for disappearing. But I really appreciate your warmth and hospitality this evening.
You're so welcome. We're very glad you could join us. It's nice to have something a bit different as well.
Thank you.
Excellent.
With that in mind, we're going to go to another video, and then I'm going to come back to Stephen for your live, Stephen, and then straight on to Paul after that. So the next one of these then is, let's have, do you know, I feel the need for Jeff's garden parody. Jeff, do you want to speak about this?
No.
Yeah, I do. Actually, I just felt someone should do this, because when they were talking about a bloody garden party, I thought, oh, yeah, you know, Rick Nielsen. You know, I went to a garden party, and then I thought, oh, okay. Yeah, that might work. And actually, I wanted to get some of the singers in my life sing, but they've been affected by COVID. Mm. So Malcolm, who I used to sing in Lemongrass with, couldn't do it. He did try. And Andy from Yonah and Andy, the Welsh couple, I put it to Andy, but they couldn't do it, any of them. So it was left to me, I'm afraid. I mean, I'm not a singist, but I had a go with this anyway. It's a bit of a parody. You can guess what it's about, the garden party, but it's based on the old Rick Nielsen song.
Well, I think it's great. Here we are.
Well, he went to a garden party just to work with some old friends. A glass of wine, a piece of cheese, the swapping lies again. And when he got to the garden party, they knew him by his hair. But no one recognized him, 'cause he wasn't even there. But it's all right now, we've learned his lesson well. So when you can't please anyone, you know you've gotta please yourself. People came from miles around, everyone was there. When Carrie brought the baby, oh, there was mischief in the air. And over in the corner, much to his surprise, Cummings there with Michael Gove, checking out his eyes. But it's all right now, we've learned his lesson well. So when you can't please anyone, you know you've gotta please yourself. Lies, 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 lies. Well, he told them all the old lies, that's all he had to say. No one heard the music, it would have given away. And he said, come on, let's raise a glass, it's nearly Christmas Eve. Did someone shout, the wine's run out, so it was time to leave. But it's all right now, we've learned his lesson well. So when you can't please anyone, you know you've gotta please yourself. Lies, 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 lies. Someone opened up a closet door, and out stepped Hancock's wench. She looked so good in the garden there, he had her on a bench. If you lie about garden parties, just you make a note, the people will remember this, you won't get a vote. But it's all right now, we've learned his lesson well. So when you can't please anyone, you know you've gotta please yourself. Lies, 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 lies. But it's all right now, we've learned his lesson well.
So when you can't please anyone, you know you've gotta please yourself.
Oh dear, that's absolutely brilliant, Jeff. Very, very good.
A bit of fun.
We're going to come to you now, Stephen. You'll need to unmute yourself. What are you going to do for us?
I'm going to do a Simon and Garfunkel song.
Brilliant.
I've come to you again. Because I'm just talking to you. Let's sing a song sleeping. Measure the heartache that brings still remains. The sound of song, silence.
Hey, well done, Stephen. Good job. Well done.
I remember that from my youth, and I'm sure Paul does as well.
Oh, I do. Yeah, love Simon and Garfunkel.
Yeah, lovely song. Yeah. Well done. Go on, sorry, Paul.
No, go on, carry on. I was only going to waffle.
I was only going to hand over to you, so waffle away.
I was just going to say there was three on the trot. There was that one, Sounds of Silence, and Homeward Bound, and I Am a Rock. And yeah. Paul Simon had me after that. I was a disciple.
Yeah, lovely. Can I just ask, Stephen, have you got a budgie or something?
Yes.
That's what it is. I can hear it.
Joining in.
Yeah, it's joining in. Fabulous.
You've got two, haven't you, Stephen?
Yeah, two, yeah.
Oh, lovely. What are they called?
AJ and Romeo.
AJ and Romeo, lovely.
Is that after Anna Jensen, Stephen?
Sorry, what was that, Ian?
Anna Jensen, Kate's sister.
My sister's called AJ. On the radio, she's called AJ.
Oh, AJ from Strictly.
Your secret's safe with us.
Oh dear. Right, I'm going to mute your budgie now, Stephen, so that Paul can sing. There we go. Handing over to you, Paul.
Okay. This is called Halcyon Days. Just have to remember how it goes. Everyone's story has a moment or two that stays with them their whole life through, like a favourite photograph inside a frame. Of a place to be where your troubles were few and the sun shone bright the whole day through, and everybody called you by your name. And though you'll never see that place and time, when you feel low, you go there in your mind. Forevermore, your own rose-tinted haze of halcyon days. St. Mary's Road in the summertime, I'm shuffling along, no reason or rhyme. There's not a single cloud in my sky. And all the while I'm singing this song, well, if it feels good, it can't be wrong. I'm living in a dream I can't deny. But there's nowhere else on earth I'd rather be. Anticipation's getting the better of me. For a southbound bus is bringing you this way for a halcyon day. And here comes Jan, she's laughing at me. She knows I'm high as I can be. She takes my hand and I feel 10 feet tall. Roses are red, violets are blue. She's the prettiest girl I ever knew. A more perfect day I can't recall. And though one day she'll leave me behind, well, right now that is the last thing on my mind. Oh, I just want to give thanks and praise for those halcyon days. Oh, everyone's story has a moment or two that stays with them their whole life through, like a favourite photograph inside a frame.
Lovely.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's a fabulous. I love that song, Paul. That's really nice.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks, Jeff.
Really nice song.
Was that one of yours?
Yeah. I'm joining in with Jeff. I think that's lovely.
Take care, Jen.
Yeah.
See you next month, Jen.
Lovely to see you, Jen.
Bye.
Another foxy costume next time, please, Jen.
Yeah, we'll be, because we'll be on stage. I've got my stage clothes.
Excellent.
Oh, stop it.
Can I just say very quickly, I asked a whole lot, but basically, Paul will actually sort of back me up on this, that I lost touch with him. We were mates, obviously, back in the 60s. And then kind of we moved away, as you do, and things happened. And then I kind of totally lost contact with him. I had no idea where he'd gone. Hadn't spoken to him for years. And Sarah did a bit of research. She found him for me. And I remember I was in the middle of a recording session for Malcolm from Lemongrass. And I got a phone call from Sarah to say, I found Paul. Now, this wasn't a mobile phone day. You didn't have mobile phones. It was actually a mobile phone. I found Paul. You're all mate, Paul. I'll never forget that because it was great to actually get back in touch with him again. And we've not actually really lost touch since, fortunately. So I'm dead proud of him as a mate. Whatever he says about my fashion sense. he couldn't play guitar back then to save his life, mind. But he can now.
Yeah, I can't tell you what a shock it was when I picked up the phone and this female voice said, are you the Paul Cornwell that used to live in Portsmouth?
Who's asking?
it may look like me, but it's not mine. But
I've got a baby in my arm here, mate.
It was great to get back in touch. No, so well done, Sarah. Yeah.
Brilliant. I've got a plan now for towards the end, and we've actually only got about four videos, I think. So I'm going to play a video and then come to you, Ian, if that's okay.
Me? Oh yeah. Yeah. There's only one Ian, isn't there, this week?
Yeah, only one Ian. There's only one Ian every week, isn't there?
No, why did I think there was...
Ian Harrison, of course.
Yeah,
Ian's not joined us this time. So so then we'll have a video and Dad, and then a video and Neil again, if you've got another one for us, Neil.
Yeah.
Yep, brilliant. And then another last video, and then Ian to play us out again. Is that all right? Yeah. I did see Maureen earlier. I was going to say hello to Maureen, but she didn't...
I'm just looking at my red nose. I've only had one gin. Your father, Jack, knows. We were trying to think of something to sing, and she's reluctant to sing anything without running through it first, which is, you know, sort of like a bit novel for me to actually rehearse.
Well, okay. Right. In that case, I'll play the next video. We'll go straight into you again after this then.
Okay.
And then you can have a think about what you want to do the next one. So I think what we're going to do... I'm going to play Bob's. This is the second of the two Bobs. Well, this is the two Bobs that I bumped from Christmas. So I'm going to play this and then we'll come to Ian.
People say a man made out of mud, for a man made from muscle and blood, muscle and blood, from skin and bones, a mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons, why do you guess? Another day older and deeper in debt. Santina, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning in sunshine. I picked up my shovel, I worked in a mine. I loaded 60 times, number 9 called. The shepherd said, well, bless my soul. You're 16 tons, why do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Say, Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Trouble with my middle name. I was raised in a cave by an old man.
my land. Ain't no hyper woman make me walk the line. You look 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Say me, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. If you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of men did, a lot of men died. One fist of iron, the other of steel. The right one don't get you, then the left one will. Another 16 tons, and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. To me, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
Yay! So that's one that Bob submitted.
About 12 Bobs.
Yeah, that was one that they submitted. We've seen it before, but they submitted it again for Christmas. But they haven't actually been able to get together since then. So I think they were going to meet up and Bob was going to take his camera, but I've not heard from him since. So maybe that didn't work out. I don't know. Anyway, hopefully we'll see them again at some point. Right, Ian, we're going to come back to you.
Right. I'm trying to persuade Maureen, so... oh, hang on, where's my posh camera? Let's see if it's still working. Doink. Yes!
Oh, it is! Look at that! Oh, I can see myself on your screen, that's
yes! Great. Yes! Doctor Who! just to explain, if I look the other way, the monitor that I'm pointing at, that has kind of like the big screen. So that's why I was completely thrown when you put the solo thing, because I had two big screens.
Oh, I see, right.
I PM'd you about it. Right. That should sound nice in your... Is it okay?
Yeah, it's good.
Desperado, why don't you come to your senses? You've been out riding fences so long now. You're a hard one. I know that you've got your reasons. These things that are pleasing you will hurt you somehow. Don't you think it cold in the wintertime? The sky won't snow and the sun won't shine. It's hard to tell the nighttime from the day. You're losing all your highs and lows. It's funny how the feeling goes away. Desperado, you know you ain't getting younger. The pain and the hunger are driving you home. And freedom, freedom, it's just some people talking. Your prison is walking through this world all alone. Cold in the wintertime, the sky will all snow and the sun won't shine. Hard to tell the nighttime from the day. Sorry about that. You're losing all your highs and lows. Ain't it funny how the feeling goes away? Desperado, why don't you come to your senses? Come down from your fence.
again. It may be raining, but there's a rainbow above you. You better let somebody love you. Let somebody love you before it's too late.
What a version.
Oh, lush that.
Yeah. Oh, brilliant. Mm. And that is one of those, that's one of those songs, Ian, that you actually played the first few notes and Sarah said, you said, oh yeah, we know this one.
Yeah, yeah. Me too. Yeah.
So recognisable, so good.
Great rendition.
Oh, yeah. Fabulous, mate. Yep.
Lovely. Really lovely. In fact, I was going to sort out my videos in between that, and I didn't. I just couldn't do anything else. I was just listening.
Whoosh.
So let's play.
Ooh.
Lush. Let's go for. Let's go for the last of Tony's for this one. So. Tony, I've played Mad World, which was brilliant, and the, what was it called, something, Shine.
Oh, yeah, Bring Your Sunshine.
Yes, so this one will be, this. What's this one? Sunny Afternoon. Do you want to say anything about this one?
Oh, Sunny Afternoon, yes. This is one of my favourite songs, actually, from all time. It's quite like the Kinks, and I've always been a big fan, so one of my favourite songs, and I think it sounds quite nice on the ukulele.
Brilliant.
So, can I just interject here? I used to play in a band like 40-odd years ago called Flicks and Slick, and it was based on Brampton area. And we got a new guitarist, a guy called Pete Matheson. Pete Matheson, he left us. When we packed in, he left to join various other bands. But he ended up on a world tour that lasted 8 years with Ray Davies as his accompanist. He had all these like American chat shows and things like that, and he says he got so fed up because Davis never ever stops touring. 24/7.
I'm liking your black and white theme here as well, Tony, this month.
Yes, I thought I'd give that a try. It's just to hide the wrinkles.
Oh, well, I quite like it. Here you are.
Sunny Afternoon, the Kinks.
The taxman's taken all my dough, left me in my stately home, blazing on a sunny afternoon. And I can't sail my yacht, he's taken everything I've got, all I've got's this sunny afternoon. In the summer.
Brilliant. Lovely.
Tony, is there any chance of you doing Sunny Afternoon? I mean, Dead End Street.
Dead End Street? Did you say? Sorry.
Yeah, Dead End Street. You know, it was one after Sunny. There's that one, and there's Autumn Almanac.
Yes, yes. Well, I'll have a look at those. I'll try and do those two on the ukulele.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. Where do you live?
Carlisle.
Oh well, I live in Cumwinton. So, do you fancy coming round and we'll do a duet? A duet.
That would be lovely. That would be absolutely lovely. Yes, I'll get your details and then maybe pop there sometime.
Yeah. We've got our own cats. You don't have to bring yours.
I have to take them wherever I go because they are the stars of the show. But no, I'll get your details via Kate and then maybe arrange to come round and do a duet with you, and that'd be absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, I was just playing along there, and the ukulele and the piano go really well together.
Yeah.
I look forward to that collaboration. That's brilliant.
Oh, yeah, lovely. Especially if it's Ray Davies songs.
Yeah.
What a fantastic writer he was.
Yeah, I just love his voice as well, and the way that the Kinks just operated. I love the sound and everything about them. Fans of those.
What a song.
Oh, yeah, tremendous, tremendous.
River, what a beautiful song.
Yeah, really? You go on and on, can't you, with them. But, that would be lovely. I would really look forward to that. Fantastic.
And Waterloo Sunset.
Yeah.
Yeah. That'd be good.
What, a request or just is it just the loop in your head going around?
No, that was an order, not a request.
All right, so we're going to come to you now, Dad, for your final contribution.
So I wondered why everybody was wearing headphones. It does sound really lovely through headphones. I put mine on. So is it to make any difference to what?
It won't make any difference to what you sound like to us, just what we sound like to you.
Okay, fine. Good, well, I'll take them off then. Yep. All right, last one is different altogether. This is a poem, and it's a poem from the 16th century. It's Thomas Wyatt, and it just shows that some things, like being entirely pissed off by love, go on forever and ever and never stop. Thomas Wyatt was in the court of Henry VIII, so he knew a bit about court Partygate, I suppose it was, wasn't it? Anyway, it starts and it sounds as if it's going to be about birds, Sir Paul, but it then goes on to be about birds. They flee from me that sometime did me seek, with naked foot stalking in me chamber. I have seen them, gentle, tame and meek, that now are wild and do not remember that sometime they put themselves in danger to take bread at my hand. And now they range, busily seeking with a continual change. Faint be fortune, it hath been otherwise 20 times better. But once in special, in thin array, after a pleasant guise, when her loose gown from her shoulders did fall, and she caught me in her arms long and small, therewithal sweetly did me kiss, and said, dear heart, how like you this? It was no dream. I lay broad waking. But all is turned through my gentleness into a strange fashion of forsaking. And I have leave to go of her goodness. And she also to use new fangleness. But since that I so kindly am served, I would fain know what she hath deserved.
Powerful stuff.
Yeah. great. Thank you, Dad. That was brilliant. Okay, so I've got two videos left. I'm going to play the final of Colin's next. Colin, do you want to speak about this one?
Yeah, it's just a different version of a tune I did last year. It is basically a Christmas song, and I recorded it for Christmas, but it ended up being surplus to requirements. So, that's it, really.
So we've got it now?
Yeah.
Perfect.
Beautiful.
Oh, it's lovely.
That's some cracking tunes, Colin.
Very lovely. Very lovely. Okay, so we're going to come back to you now, Neil.
Okay. Excuse me. I've got a handsome prince in my throat. I don't know what this is. It's a traditional sort of song, but it's called Roving on a Winter's Night. I'm not really sure what roving is. It's something that involves drink and sort of wicked thoughts, I think. So it's.
Is like some budding rose, flowers in the month of June. She's like a music instrument that's just been really tuned. Roving on, you can join in. Winter's night. Thinking of that pretty girl.
some foreign land. Maybe France, maybe Spain. If I go 10,000 miles, well, I'm coming back again. Roving on the winter's night, drinking all that good old wine, thinking all that pretty girl I broke his heart of mine. Tell me who will shoe your little foot, tiny hand, who will kiss your ruby lips? Tell me who would be your man. And my mother will chew my little foot. My mother will glove my tiny hand. My ruby lips, but you'll never be my man. Roving on the winter's night, drinking all that good old wine, thinking all that pretty girl. Dry. All the rocks melt in the sun. I love her till the day I die. She'll never be my own. Rolling on winter's night.
That love is handsome and when it is new but fades away like morning dew, because they all have that verse in. Yeah. Great song, well done.
Yeah.
Really enjoyed that.
Okay, so we've got one more video left, the last of Cultrums. So Jeff, do you want to talk about this one? And then we're going to come to Ian and Maureen to play us out.
Yeah, I was slightly hoping that Michelle might have been able to join us after her rehearsing.
I don't think they're finished yet.
No, I think it sounds like a whole bunch of fun from what she tells me. But anyway, this is a song that it was actually a country song originally by a duo called Brooks and Dunn, who I listened to and thought actually brilliant back in 1991, '92, '93, and. I've always loved this song. It gets played a lot. And it seems, judging from Annalise, who is Michelle's daughter, that actually it seems to have taken off. It's got a TikTok dance to it and all sorts. Because when Michelle was doing it at home, she was going through it, Annalise said to her, oh, I didn't know you were doing that one. And Michelle said, what one? You don't know this, do you? Because it's like a country song, which Jeff's told me about, you know. And apparently, no, it's a bit of an internet sensation. So, but it's a beautiful song. And I think Michelle, again, I think she does a great version of it. And I am a bit, again, responsible for some harmonies on this, I have to say. So don't listen too carefully. But this is, yeah, it's a song called Neon Moon.
Sun goes down on this side of town, that lonesome feeling comes to my door, and the whole world turns blue. And there's a rundown bar across the railroad track, got a table for two way in the back, where I sit alone, think of losing you. I spend most every night beneath the light of a neon moon. If you lose your one and only, there's always room here for the lonely to watch your broken dreams dance in and out of the beams of a neon moon. I think of two young lovers running wild and free. I close my eyes and sometimes see you in the shadows of this smoke-filled room. No telling how many tears I've sat here and cried, or how many lies that I've lied, telling my poor heart he'll come back someday. Oh, but I'll be alright as long as there's light from a neon moon. Oh, if you lose your one and only, there's always room here for the lonely to watch your broken dreams dance in and out of the beams of a neon moon. And the words of every sad song seem to say what I think, and this hurt inside of me ain't never gonna end. Oh, but I'll be alright as long as there's light from a neon moon. Oh, if you lose your one and only, there's always room here for lonely to watch your broken dreams dance in and out of the beams of a neon moon. Oh, if you lose your one and only, there's always room here for the lonely to watch your broken dreams dance in and out of the beams of a neon moon. If you lose your one and only, there's always room here for the lonely to watch your broken dreams dance in and out of the beams of a neon moon.
Oh, super.
Lovely song.
Yeah.
Never heard lovely. That before.
No, I haven't. Very nice. Very nice. I'm going to have to look for that on TikTok now.
Yeah.
see what that's all about.
Yeah, it is a lovely song. I had no idea about it being on TikTok. I just knew it as being a song that I'd loved from way back.
Well, I can't imagine why it's gone viral, because the first thing that's come up is that. I don't know what's going on there.
Don't look, Ethel.
Oh, dear. Right. Well, that's it. We've got, we're through all the videos. Thank you so much for all your contributions, video-wise and live performance-wise. It's been a really good night tonight. It's sort of started a bit quiet and got busier as we went on, which is a bit topsy-turvy to what it normally is. But anyway, I'm so glad you could all join us. It's been good. And hopefully next month we'll be back in the theatre and back to hybrid. Fingers crossed for that. Beginning of March, that will be. I don't know the date off the top of my head. What's the 1st of March? Anyone know? I'm not sure. Fourth again?
Fourth. No.
Oh, yeah.
We can't.
Yeah, fourth of March.
We've got a Cumbrian night that night.
Oh, you have, yes. Okay, so you won't be joining us that night then?
No, unfortunately not, no.
Right, okay. So, we will. We won't see you next time then, but we'll see you the month after that, hopefully. All right, well, in that case, this will be the last we hear from you for a couple of months, so you can play us out.
Okay.
Hi, Maureen, by the way. I didn't get to say it before. You sloped off again before.
I've been sorting the laundry out.
Glamorous.
Oh, that's such an exciting week.
Fortnite.
Oh. we're gonna cheer ourselves up. I was gonna sing something miserable, but we're gonna sing something. And this is back
it,
to.
It might be the right key.
It might be the
we're
right key.
We're not sure.
Yeah, we'd like to apologise before we start. Yeah.
I don't want your lonely mansion with a tear in every room. All I want is the love you promised beneath the haloed moon. But you think I should be happy with your money and your name, and hide myself in sorrow while you play your cheating game. Silver threads and golden needles cannot mend this heart of mine, and I dare not drown my sorrows in the warm glow of your wine. You can't buy my love with money, for I never was that kind. Silver threads and golden needles cannot mend this heart of mine.
Is it too fast?
It's too long as well.
Oh. I'll go up to G. People think it's class. You want it slower?
Silver threads and golden needles cannot mend this heart of mine, and I dare not drown my sorrows in the warm glow of your wine. You can't buy my love with money, for I never was that kind. Silver threads and golden needles cannot mend this heart of mine. I don't want your lonely mansion with a tear in every room. All I want's the love you promised beneath the haloed moon. But you think I should be happy with your money and your name, and hide myself in sorrow while you play your cheating game. Silver threads and golden needles cannot mend this heart of mine, and I dare not drown my sorrows in the warm glow of your wine. You can't buy my love with money, for I never want that kind. Silver threads and golden needles cannot mend this heart of mine.
silver threads and golden needles. I don't know how it finishes. Oh, I can't remember how it finishes.
Silver threads and golden needles cannot mend this heart of mine.
Oh.
Yay! brilliant. Excellent. Thank you both very much. That was brilliant. I like it. Nice, light-hearted ending.
You mean everybody's glad to get away?
I didn't say that. Off you go. No, that was fab. Thank you very much. Right, well, that's it. We've done for February. So we'll be back March and hopefully see you all then. And look after yourselves. Hopefully we'll be one panto under our belts and the theatre will be back to kind of in the normal running of timings and things. Have a good Cumbrian night.
Thank you. Thank you again, Kate. You always run it really well. I was at a Zoom thing the other week. Oh, it was just a train crash. And I thought, I miss Kate.
Well,
Kate, I think Kate has to sort of keep up the professional front amongst us, Ian, doesn't she?
What are you saying? I don't like your insidation.
On that note, I'm going to bid you all a farewell.
Good night.
Bye. Take care, everyone.
Bye, everyone.
Bye, everybody.
Bye. Bye. Thanks, everyone.